Hey, what's up? This is Doug with Design 8 Studio, and I am cutting some XZ plates so that I can upgrade my LowRider version 3 to a newer version. It's not actually come out yet. I'm part of the beta team, and the XZ plate that's being cut now is actually for a release candidate. And I love watching these fat chips fly. I finally got the feeds and speeds right and finally figured out that one of the problems I was struggling with was I started off with a bit that I thought was sharp but wasn't. And so before I got this great success in trochoidal milling that you see happening here, I had tried both trochoidal milling and conventional milling with a bit that I later found out was not sharp. Here you see me trying trochoidal milling, and the problem with this particular attempt, I eventually found out, was simply that the bit was not sharp enough. And as I mentioned, I then also, without realizing that a dull bit was my issue, I then switched to conventional milling. I made a little bit of headway with that, but it proved to be really problematic. And again, it all came down to later. I found that although the bit was just mistakenly presumed to still have some sharpness to it, there was actually a discussion on the V1 engineering forum in which it was pointed out that a bit can still kind of look sharp and you think it's still got some life in it. And one of the forum members actually got out his Vivor microscope thing, and I had actually purchased one of those as well. And he checked his bit and saw where the cutting edge was just gone. And so I thought, I'm not going to waste any more time trying to do half-depth trochoidal milling, which is what you see happening here. That half-depth effort was because I saw deflection happening and saw that the cuts just weren't happening. Look at those chips. They're tiny. They're almost like the sawdust version. And then here it was my effort at conventional milling. And again, look at the chips. They're little tiny chips. And it's almost like it's plowing its way through instead of cutting its way through. And it is making chips, but they're just really small. And so in order to get those nice fat chips, it requires not only having a sharp bit, but also having the right feeds and speeds. And so I started off with some feeds and speeds that I got from one of the forum members who had done some successful cutting. And then as I started in with a brand new bit, nice and sharp, I realized that it sounded like I needed to go a little faster. So I used the feed rate override feature of Fluid and C, which when you're running a job with this fluid dial pendant, then it's easy to increase your feed rate just by spinning the dial. So I spun it up. I increased it, I think, to 155%. And so when you see me putting these feeds and speeds on the screen, that includes compensating for that increase, because that got me to a really great place where that sharp bit was chewing in and getting these nice, fat, full-length, 6 millimeter tall chips. And that's exactly what you want to see. So folks, this is done with version 3 LowRider. It's just a tremendous machine. And the reports are that the newer version that's coming out is going to be considerably better. But I got to tell you, the version 3 is just impressive. And again, if you're struggling with cutting aluminum and you know your feeds and speeds are supposed to be right, then get a brand new sharp bit out and watch what a difference it makes. Sure made a difference for me.
All right, let's get the vacuum and suck up all those gorgeous fat chips of aluminum, and I'll remove the part that just got cut and we'll show it to you. You can see some of my drilling on the first op didn't get quite all the way through. I'll just use a 1/8 inch drill bit and punch those the rest of the way through. That's done with a LowRider version 3, which is basically making parts for its own replacement. Hey, this has been Doug with Design 8 Studio, and until the next video, I wish you happy making.